I'll use this one. Ooh, that's a lot better, isn't it? I am absolutely floored by the turnout. I am so grateful you guys are here. What you are about to see is the culmination of, oh God, probably 40 years of dreaming. About a year and a half ago, several people got together and formed a partnership, and we did something unprecedented in Star Trek fandom, and that was we acquired a 9,600 square foot building in Georgia where we rebuilt the entire soundstage from the original series of Star Trek. I'm not talking about a set or two, I'm talking about all of it. And it was all laid out exactly the way the original series was, everything connected and with meticulous detail. And then we started casting, and we put together a great group of people that loved Star Trek and had some acting background and were so excited to be a part of this. And about 6 months ago, we shot a couple of little vignettes. And then in January of this year, we shot our first episode. And we are very, very excited to share it with you tonight for the first time ever. So we're just all gonna sit here and have a good time watching Star Trek together. Pilgrim of Eternity is the name of the episode. I think you'll recognize a lot of familiar faces in the episode. And when it's done, we'll have the cast and crew up on stage to do a Q&A session with you and answer any questions you have about what you're about to see. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being here. Please enjoy Star Trek Continues, Episode 1.
Any idea what caused it?
For this premiere by Ms. Nichelle Nichols. Please give her a round. Oh, thank you. I told her, you have to come. Wait till you see what we do to Uhura. Oh my goodness. I am going to invite up on stage our cast. Please give them a round of applause. First and foremost, please welcome Mr. Michael Forrest, Apollo, ladies and gentlemen. And then please welcome Larry Nemechek, Dr. McCoy. Lieutenant Uhura, my lovely Michelle Specht as Dr. Elise McKenna. I can't remember who else. Oh yes! Please welcome Grant Imahara. And one of my new favorite best friends, ladies and gentlemen, Chris Dewin. actually would like to invite, we've got a new crew member who's going to be our chief of security. He will be featured more prominently coming up, but please welcome Mr. Stephen Dangler. Come on up, Steve. I'm not going to let you get away either. You guys, more Star Trek royalty. I would love to have Mr. Doug Drexler come up and join us on the panel. He's responsible for the beautiful Enterprise you just saw flying by.
Love you, man!
You can't escape. The doors have been locked. Let's see, who else can we bring up to join us? Yes, please, you know what? We had a wonderful assistant director on this production. Where is Chris White? Come on up here, Chris. Please welcome Chris White. Please welcome our production supervisor, Casey Shafsky. Come on up, Casey. And please welcome our makeup supervisor, Lisa Hansel. Please, come on up. You guys, please welcome the two gentlemen that we love that wrote the episode for us, Steve Fratt and Jack Trevino. Come on up here. I'm sorry. Too many people, I can't remember. Pardon me? Thank you. You know what? I'm going to start right off with that. You guys, let me tell you how this came about, and then we're going to have questions and answers with you guys, anything you'd like to talk about. About a year and a half ago, I was invited to direct an episode for an amazing web series that many of you may know of called Starship Farragut. And I became very good friends with these guys. We had a great time together. And so after this wonderful experience we had, we started talking about kind of partnering up and combining our skills and our talents and basically creating more together than we could ever alone. And so we acquired, as I told you, this amazing building down in Jacksonville, Florida. And Mike Bednar of Farragut Films was in charge of production of getting these sets built. I've got to acknowledge Matt Busey, who is not here. Matt Busey is the genius behind the director of photography. Matt was the director of photography on this. He's a brilliant individual. And he also took the original plans of the original series sets and basically extrapolated all of the measurements and dimensions and everything. So the sets that you're seeing are spot on to the original sets in their size and shape and dimension and everything about them. And Mike Bednar and his team of the Farragut guys were basically charged with the responsibility of building these sets. And it took a long time, as you can imagine. But we spared no expense and made them absolutely breathtaking. And it's really amazing to walk through them. They're not like one over here, one over there. They are literally interconnected. You can walk down the corridor, into the briefing room, back down the corridor, into the transporter room, across the hall, into the sick bay. Everything is laid out exactly as it was. In fact, one of the shots that we took, you saw where Kirk came running down the corridor and into the transporter room. We specifically set that shot up so that people would see, this is all interconnected. They came right out of the corridor into the transporter room. And John Broughton of Farragut Films, you would know him as Captain Carter from that series, he was in charge of our wardrobe, and we spent the last year or so building these amazing sets. And as a matter of fact, they are located in Kingsland, Georgia, a beautiful town right outside of Jacksonville, Florida. And we are actually talking about organizing tours. Yeah. Because I gotta tell you something, if you like Star Trek half as much as I do, to get to walk through the sets exactly as they were laid out, I don't believe there has been a larger standing recreation of the sets ever since 1969. So that is something you can be looking on our website, StarTrekContinues.com. You can be looking for information about getting the chance to tour the facility. You could get married there. How about getting married on the bridge and having your reception in the briefing room, in the rec room, and then beam off to the honeymoon? I love it.
And having your honeymoon in the captain's quarters.
I'll personally beam you out.
And so keep your eyes on the website. I mean, corporate events, there are plenty of possibilities for it, but it's a beautiful facility. And by the way, we're still building. We will be building McCoy's lab next door to the sick bay. We're still working on several new things to just continue to embellish it and make it the most amazing sets. So please, you guys, even though they're not here in absentia, please give a round of applause to Mike Bednar and his team for the amazing sets in the set. Let's open it up to some questions. We'd like to hear from you guys. So did they set up a microphone down there? Okay, there are mics on both sides. If you guys would like to, right here, if you have a question, feel free to come down. Anything you want to know about the episode you just saw, please come down and ask us. We'd love to talk with you.
My question is, were you guys like all friends during the casting?
Were we all friends?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
We're not friends now. No, I'm just kidding.
we were friends at the beginning of filming. Yeah. No. Everybody is actually, this is a wonderful group of people led by Vic Mignogna, and it is one of the most incredible things to be involved with this group of people who are so loving and caring, dedicated, and extremely talented. It's unbelievable.
Vic, what do you mean more?
Yeah, but Mike, doesn't he mispronounce his own name, doesn't he?
When I first met Vic, I forget exactly how he was pronouncing his name. And I said, Vic, you're Italian, right? The pronuncia in Italiano si dice Mignogna. And he still doesn't know how to pronounce it.
You can school me anytime, Apollo. You guys, let me say something I just thought of real quick. It's very important that it's probably a question you'll have, but I want to say this. We are not making a penny from this. It's very important that you know this. Star Trek is a licensed property, as you know. Well, except all the money we gave Chris, except for that. But you know what this is? This is the most gigantic labor of love. We all have an affinity and a childhood love of Star Trek, and we wanted to do something special together. So the people that donated their time and their money and their talents and their efforts did it purely for love of Star Trek. And that is all.